This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a recently diagnosed patient who wants to know, what are my best initial or frontline therapy options? And obviously a very key, important question. This particular gentleman is in his 70s and so most likely is not a candidate or interested in pursuing autologous stem cell transplant. And so in his case, the recommended regimen is a very excellent recommendation of the combination of daratumumab, Revlimid, and dexamethasone, a three-drug triplet regimen called the Maya regimen, which has produced excellent results with average remissions which exceed 4 years. And so this really excellent regimen is what is called the standard of care for non-transplant patients in the frontline setting. For patients who are considering autologous stem cell transplantation, the Maya regimen can also be used, but typically we use the Velcade, Revlimid, and dexamethasone regimen as a first choice to achieve that first remission with the idea to consider the use of autologous stem cell transplant. So the choices are clear and the benefits are really good. There are a number of backup regimens that can be considered. For example, instead of Revlimid, one can use thalidomide or Cytoxan. Instead of Velcade, one can consider Kyprolis, which is carfilzomib, especially in the high-risk setting. There are a number of options. If a patient is more frail, one can use a doublet, Velcade and dexamethasone, particularly if there are kidney problems, or just simply Revlimid and dex, an all-oral regimen, which works well for an older patient. The answer to this particular patient is that the options are rather clear. The only new thing to consider is the possibility to use four drugs, a quadruplet rather than a triplet. And adding daratumumab, an anti-CD38 monoclonal antibody, or isatuximab, another one, to give a four-drug regimen such as dara-VRD or isa-VRD, these are options, and we just need more data to indicate if this would really become a new standard of care moving forward. So bottom line, options pretty clear. Either daratumumab Rev-Dex, the Maya regimen, or possibly Velcade, Revlimid, and dexamethasone, particularly if any high-risk features have been noted on bone marrow FISH testing.